Hello all, we are here today this morning for a very important session with Mr. Anoop Vashisht, who's MSc in chemistry from Delhi University. He's a NEET coach and a motivational speaker, and he has over 23 years of teaching experience, and he's mentored over 5 lakh students. And you know, he's responsible, he's produced All India rank ones in AIIMS, AIPMT, DPMT, and AIR 17 in IIT. And, we are going to try and attempt to help all the students who are not able to go to their schools, go to their coaching institutes to learn and, to be physically present in the class and interact with their teachers face to face. So, sir, good morning. How are you today?
Good morning. How are you?
Very fine, sir. So, sir, shall we begin our interview, sir?
Perfect.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Start. So the first important question is, as the competitive exams are being postponed for students, what should the students do currently?
First of all, they should not even look at the postponement of the exams. They should consider that the exams are to be held on the same date as they have been scheduled on. Because of that, if they consider the postponement, then in that case, their preparation also is going to be delayed. And that's what is not suggested at the moment. So what I would suggest is that they should keep on preparing as if the exams are going to be held on the announced date. If the exams are postponed, that would give them an extra time for revision, which they can utilize to restart for that particular duration. They should not delay their preparation. They should not look for the postponement. They should not change their schedule because of it. Follow the schedule that you have made and complete it accordingly.
It's a great learning. So all the students, please make sure that you follow the schedule and don't consider that the exam was ever postponed. So the next question, sir, I want to ask you, because you've spoken about competitive exams. I want to talk about schools, sir. A lot of schools are passing students without the typical end of year exams. What should the students be thinking about it? What should they be doing about it? What do you think about this whole thing about not having the final exams?
Well, I would consider it highly unfortunate. Because this final year exams allowed the student to revise the entire year syllabus and they became prepared for the next class. Whenever we have the next class, these are in continuation. Every further class, like we talk about the eighth class uses the concept of the seventh class to build the further concepts. Similarly, if we talk about the ninth class uses the concepts learned in eighth class to build up the concept. 10th class, very obviously, and most crucial is the 11th class. The 11th class uses 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, all the concepts to build over it. We all know that 11th class has been considered the most difficult class and it is a very difficult transition from 10th to 11th. And that is difficult when the students have prepared for their 10th board and they have revised all the concepts. Now, in this case, when the students have not revised their concepts and they are just going to go into the 11th class, that is going to be extremely difficult transition. So I would consider it highly unfortunate, but this is not in hands of anybody. This was a compulsion. Obviously, the government has not taken this decision because of a whims or fancies. These decisions have been taken because of certain very logical considerations. Now, this was a compulsion. Now, my sincere suggestion to the student would be that you prepare as if you are going to take the 10th exam.
Okay.
You need to. Okay, I would suggest that you make a series of certain mock tests and you take the exam on your own. Okay. Prepare for it. Properly prepare for it and take the exam on your own. You can even take the help of your teachers. Because I don't think so that any school teacher is going to refuse this kind of an opportunity if the student wants to study. They can have certain unofficial tests. You can take the test sitting at your home with honesty. Send your papers, scan them, and send it to your teachers. They would really appreciate it. And you also will have a chance to revise the entire syllabus. This is going to help you a lot. So that is my suggestion to all the students.
Great, great suggestion, sir. So, students should, create mock tests. Students should, actually try to give the exams themselves and be in touch with the teachers who would appreciate such an action by the students, sir. Now, sir, there are a lot of, online teaching that has started, some, intentionally, some unintentionally. So with no end in sight for the COVID-19 pandemic, do you think we need to relook at the pattern, the typical pattern of teaching and learning, and replace it completely with online or a hybrid-based system even after the pandemic? Should this continue, sir?
At this moment, online coaching has become a necessity. It is a necessity. This is the only way that we can go ahead. So this online coaching at this moment, whatever it is, whether people consider it as a flaw, whether people consider it as a boon, everybody has different kind of looks, different kind of things about the online coaching. Some consider it as a boon. There's some consider that they are able to study in the comfort of their home. Some people think that the physical presence of a teacher, which was there in the offline coaching, that is absent in the online coaching. See, everything has pros and cons. It all depends on the person. Like I say, the knife. Knife can be used to cook food. It can be used to cut food. And knife can also be used to kill people. The same is true with the online education. The people who can get the benefit out of online education, they consider that they are having online education, sitting at their home, they are not wasting their time. They are able to see the classes at any time. It is 24/7 presence. They are able to get the educators, different educators. All the educators are present. They are able to use that facility. But other people, they are using it as an escape. They simply switch on the class, they go to sleep, and the class is going on. They are getting their attendance, but they are not studying at all. So there are all kind of people. So it's something like, it is up to you how you use it. But it is something like that the education system was lacking the presence of technology. The chalk and duster approach has been going on for a time immemorial. Now, I think that chalk and duster approach needs to be reinforced. I'm not saying replaced. I'm saying reinforced. Absolutely. So let us reinforce the chalk and duster approach by technology.
Absolutely.
That is going to benefit us a lot.
So, you know, go ahead, sir.
It is going to be more like a hybrid system. That is going to get. Now, in this hybrid system, what is going to be the proportion of the online and what is going to be the proportion of the offline? That is going to be decided by the teachers and the students. Okay. So that is my take on this particular situation.
So, you know, just a continuing question to this one. Do you think students who are learning only through the online mode will be learning less as compared to the offline mode? Or is it a more enhanced way of learning due to technology boost, audio video based learning, and all the extra things that have come?
Here I would like to give an example. While teaching also, I take a lot many examples. Let us say you are in a relative's house and you are having food. Now, what the relative does is, let's have one chapati more, please have it, please have this, please have that. And they make you eat more than what you can. That's one situation. The second situation, you are in a buffet. You have huge number of stalls and you have huge number of foods and you are at a liberty to eat everything or nothing. Now, that is the case with online and offline coaching. Offline coaching is sitting at your relative house who are going to push you, like teachers are going to push in the offline coaching. Study this, study this. They are standing on your head and you are making you study. And the online coaching is a buffet system. Whatever you want to eat, you can eat. But remember, when you have the relative's house, there is a limited number of dishes that you have. But you are made to eat them all. If you have a buffet, you have a huge number of selection. But you have a choice what you want to eat or not. Now, on what does it depend on? The success of online coaching depends on the student. So if the student wants to take the benefit of the online coaching, nothing is better than that. But if a kind of student is there who does not want to attain, then there is, for that student, it's an offline coaching. It has to be a relative place. Beta, tu usi to kuch khanda hi nahi. Khao. So that forcibly is going to take place in the offline coaching. Online is entirely the self-motivation.
So with this, we come to a very appropriate question. How can a student make the best of the online classes?
First thing, the student needs to be self-motivated. He needs to understand that it is for his betterment that he's studying. It is not for the mother's case. Like, my mom wants me to be a doctor, or my father wants me to be an engineer. If your mother and father want to be that engineer or doctor, then in that case, you are going to say that you study. I'm not going to study. They have to force you to study. But offline can go a little because of that. Offline, they may push you, but online, nobody can push you. Online, you have to be self-motivated. You have to say that you want to become a doctor. You want to become an engineer. Then only online can be successful. Online is not able to push you. That is the biggest drawback of online. And if the person is self-motivated, this is the biggest positive boon of online.
Okay, okay. So you know, I want to ask you like a question related to this one. So for example, you know, if it is a live class and the student has missed the online class due to COVID sickness or due to taking care of a family member who has COVID sickness, should he rely on the recording of the online class? Are recordings as good as live classes?
The biggest positive thing about the online classes is that all the institute that offer online classes, they offer the recording as well. That is the biggest positive of the online classes. And frankly speaking, if you don't tell yourself that this is a recording, you will not be able to get the difference because this is the recording of the actual class.
Okay.
The only thing that you would be missing is that you would not be asking the doubts in the live class. In the live class, you have an option of asking the doubts as well. This is what you are going to miss. So what you can do is you can simply note down the doubts and you can ask the student, the teacher in any of the doubt sessions or any of the other online classes that you are going to attend. Or you can take the time from the teacher directly that, okay, these are the doubts I have missed because of my certain situations.
Absolutely.
And you can clear those doubts. Okay. So that is the advantage of the online classes. See, there are a lot many courses starting every day. When you talk about the online classes. So that is a possibility that if you miss one course, certain classes of the course, you can attend those classes in the other course as well.
Absolutely.
If that is possible, that is an excellent thing. If that is not possible, then in that case, of course, you can rely on the recording and ask the doubt from the teacher later.
Okay.
There is a possibility that if you are not a very doubtful person, then in that case, you might not even realize that this is a recording.
Okay. So, you know, from the teacher's side, if I want to ask you a question, from the teacher's side, if there's a live class going on and, you know, we have this concept of a teacher-student ratio in an offline class, is there this concept of the teacher-student ratio in an online class? And what is the appropriate teacher-student ratio in an online class, sir?
The thing is, the online class, from my point of view, they don't depend on the teacher-student ratio.
Okay.
The online class depend on the teacher and doubtful student ratio.
Okay.
It is all about the students asking the doubts.
Okay.
If the students are not asking the doubt, then in that case, the ratio of 1:1,000 or 1:10,000 also won't make any difference. Because every student gets the front row seat in every online class.
Absolutely.
So student doesn't even know that there is another student in the class until unless the other student asks the doubt. So it all depends on the collection of the students. If the students are doubt-free students, and the teacher is able to clear their doubts without the student asking that doubt, then in that case, any ratio would be excellent.
But what is the case of a doubt, class which has a lot of doubts?
In that case, it all depends on the offline ratio also. When we talk about the offline classes also, there are also the doubtful students. They make the class either very much dragged or interesting. So, वो है ना कहते हैं ना कि बर्बाद गुलिस्ता करने को बस एक ही उल्लू काफी है तो when there are a lot many people who are having doubts then in that case too many students then in that case the ratio would be something like 1:2 would also be too much
understood. Now
so it all depends on the kind of students and teachers
yeah
there isn't any ideal ratio here
thank you for your view on this sir now you know what, you know, like people, students, you know, sometimes in non-competitive classes, students have started to complain about long hours in front of the screen. So what do teachers do to cope with the stress, so-called, that students have because of being in front of the screen the whole day for the school classes, competitive classes, all the classes, they have to be, you know, stuck in front of their screen. What do you think about this, sir?
Do we have an option? That is the question.
Okay.
The simple thing is, do we have an option? Like we are sitting in the air conditioners, it's not good. But do we have an option?
Mm.
We are stuck up at the home. Do we have an option?
Mm.
Why do we complain when we don't have an option?
Yeah. So we should complain when we have an option.
Of course, you can, you are complaining. Wait, that is the question. Either change yourself or change the situation. If you can't do both of them, any of them, don't complain.
Okay.
Well, that is one thing. That is one way to look at this situation, that you don't have an option. So what are you going to gain by complaining? Absolutely. Further, second thing, you can take certain precautions, like don't sit in the front of the screen for a very long duration. Let us say 50 minutes, you sit in the front of the screen and then you give the rest to your eyes. That doesn't mean that you start playing on your mobile phone. These students who are complaining that they are sitting in front of the screen for a long duration, were they sitting in front of the walls earlier? Were they not playing on the mobiles? Were they not watching the television? Were they not playing the games? At that time, they were not complaining. But now they are studying and they start complaining. Why? Why do they do it? The thing is, work for 50 minutes, give 10 minutes break to your eyes, close your eyes, do some kind of a massage, go and wash your face, give the rest, 10 minutes rest, and then you start. And who is asking you to sit in the front of the screen for 24 hours? The classes don't go for 24 hours. Why are you sitting for 24 hours in the front of the screen? Your classes may go on for, school classes may go on for 3 hours. The coaching classes may go on for 3 hours, 6 hours in a day. That is 24 hours. You are sitting in the front of the screen for 6 hours. What are you doing for the other 12 hours? Why are you sitting in the front of the screen for the other 12 hours? And then you complain that your eyes are showing fatigue.
Yeah.
Don't complain.
I thought we had to make this student, popular for the students. This video should be popular for the students. So I hope we'll nag them a little less, sir. And we'll go to the next question, sir.
Well, remember.
Yeah.
Here we would say, like to say, I have interrupted you, but here we would like to say that this is what we say as a cruel love.
Cruel love.
This is what the concept of cruel love.
Absolutely.
We have to be cruel to be kind.
Yeah.
Today, if we coddle the student, then in that case, they will end up sacrificing their career. The entrance examination are not going to wait for them. The entrance examination are not going to look at their excuses that they could not study because of the COVID, because there are a hell lot of students who are making this situation as an opportunity. They have converted this situation as an opportunity and they are studying 24/7.
Because they don't have to go anywhere. They don't have to, attend anything. They just have to study. So it's a golden opportunity, as you're saying.
The people were taking non-attending schools. At this moment, they don't have to take any kind of non-attending schools. They have been forced to do non-attending. So many of the people who are thinking about non-attending or homeschooling, they have got all the advantages.
Absolutely.
And those kind of students are going to leave the students who are complaining far behind. What we are going to look, what my opinion is that when we see that this situation are going to abate, then we are going to see two classes of the students. There is not going to be any middle class. There is going to be one class of the student who are top of the line, who have made the best use of this situation. And there would be another category of the students who have done nothing.
Okay.
So there would be two kind of situation. There isn't going to be any middle student. Student who have done something, there isn't going to be anyone, because the people who are doing something, they are doing nothing.
Understood.
So I have to be a teacher. I can't be kind of coddling the students and making them feel good about what they are doing.
Okay.
I have to show them that you have to make your career, you have to make your life. And this is if you think this is the best opportunity that anyone could have got, this is something like, if you ask your parents might say, if we had got this kind of an opportunity, we would have topped in our exams. And you are getting this opportunity placed on, I don't know what kind of, I should say, this is a pandemic, this is a worse situation, but you can make best out of it if you
absolutely.
Wish to.
Absolutely, absolutely, sir. And, there's this concern about, teachers having a connect, seeing the student's face and the students seeing the teacher's face all the time when the class is going on. And, a lot of concern regarding, bandwidth issues. The teachers sometimes ask all the students to switch off their camera sometimes. So do you think there is some problem with, not being able to see the student's face, and, how can students still maintain, teachers still can maintain some decorum in the class and still can maintain the connect with the students when their cameras are off?
It is all depending on the student again.
Okay.
If the student does not want to study, he has all the options of not studying.
Yeah, now it's all there.
Even if, even if the cameras were on, still the students have got lot many options. They are so techno savvy that even if the cameras are on, teacher won't be able to find out whether the students are attentive or not. So they are very much techno savvy, and I perfectly know it. So it is all boils down to single fact, whether the student wants to study or not. If they don't want to study, they will find thousands of ways not to. And if they want to study, they will get one way to study.
Absolutely. So it
all boils down to the same thing, whether the students are attentive, whether the students want to make the best use of it or not. Teachers, they do try. They try to get the offline feel in the online, but that is not possible.
Yeah.
Okay. And the bandwidth issue, they can be from any side. The teachers are there taking the classes from their home. Every teacher does not have the opportunity that they can get 100 Mbps or 200 Mbps connection. When I'm taking my classes, I have got three internet connections with me. But every person is not going to get it. They might not have that kind of connection in their area. Many of the teachers have to take the classes depending on their mobile phone internet data.
Yeah.
Many of the students have to depend on that. Many of the students are in remote areas.
Absolutely.
So it has to, and we have to work on all the situations. What kind of situations that we have? We have to work on that. Great. We have to make the best use of whatever resources we have. You have an option. You complain or you change. It's your wish.
So when you're saying all these good things, sir, you know, we're about to reach the end of the interview. And I also want to ask you a question of hope. If there is one thing, if there's one wish that you wanted to come true, what would it be?
The students getting successful.
Oh.
And okay. Students getting sincere. That is the biggest wish I have. I really wish that the students become sincere, they remain sincere, and they make their career to the best of their capacities. Just don't waste time. That is my sincere suggestion. I would not like to say the word advice, because the students don't take the word advice nicely. I would not say that's a command. I would simply say suggestion. Use this suggestion. And I'm saying this suggestion from the experience that I have. I have experienced more than most of the people. And that is why I'm suggesting you make the best of the situation. This situation is not that bad of the studies as the people may have thought about it. It has certain good things about it, and you can utilize it.
Absolutely, sir. Thank you so much. You know, you have brought in so much light and enlightenment to these all the questions that I had asked you. And, you know, I'm sure a lot of students are going to get inspired, encouraged, and there is going to be an increase in their hope right now. As you know, we see a lot of bad news around. We see a lot of, you know, distress all around. But, you know, a student who's trying to study, he can always go ahead, as you have been telling us, go ahead with the studies, go ahead with this competition exam, go ahead with the school, and think not about the situation, but think about, as you're saying, his sincerity and his success. So, sir, great. It was great having you. You want to close this by saying something?
Yeah, I would really like to thank you that you allowed me to express my views on this session so that I could reach the students, hopefully a lot many students, by the way of you and your channel. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.